Hey folks, welcome to the Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. In today's episode, we're going to be anodizing titanium. That's right, if you want to change the color of titanium, this is a chemical process that you can do to change its color. This is really popular for folding knives. A lot of folding knives have titanium parts that you want to change the color of. That's exactly what I'm doing here. I have some titanium liners on a folder I'm working on, and I need them to be kind of a copper color. Let's go down to the table and take a look. So this is what we're going to try and anodize. These are two liners to the folding knife that I'm working on, and the pivot head that I'd like to match the same color. So we're going to be doing them at the same time so that we get exact same color on all of these pieces. So how are we going to do that? Here's everything we're going to need. We've got a DC power supply, a dish that we're going to be using to hold the actual parts in the solution. We have some distilled water and some baking soda. First thing we're going to do is mix our solution. So I've got 2 cups of distilled water. I'm going to mix 2 tablespoons of baking soda, and we're going to let that mix until it fully dissolves and goes back to clear. Now I'm going to pour our solution into our container here. Okay, so I've got this set up. The cathode is on a piece of copper that's sitting into the solution. You can use titanium copper. It doesn't really matter for this one. For the other one that the pieces are actually connected to, this is a piece of titanium wire. So I'm going to put a test piece in here first before my actual pieces and connect it. And I'm going to run this around 13 volts because I want a copperish color. So let's try it. If you folks need anything for knife making, whether it's steel, abrasives, tooling, you name it, go check out Maritime Knife Supply. They'll help you out and they have quick shipping. Get it to you nice and fast. Okay, so I've got my test piece submerged, connected to the wire. I'm going to turn on my DC power supply. I made sure I don't have anything connected right now. I preset it at about 13 volts. And make sure you don't connect this, complete the circuit here with your body or anything like that. Hence, I'm wearing rubber gloves. And I'm going to just connect this now to the wire. And we should see some pretty quick changes here. I can see it bubbling. It's pretty immediate. That's kind of a gold color. Not exactly what I'm looking for. So I'm going to up the voltage a little bit and see if we can get something just a little more coppery. So there's the color that I came out with. That's at 14.5 volts. I did play around with it a couple different variations, but that seems to be the closest I'm going to get to a copper color, and I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, let's try the other parts. So here we go with the rest of the parts. It certainly doesn't take long. So I think these are going to work for the application I need for this folding knife. You guys will see a short of that knife maybe next week. But remember that you can vary the color of the anodization using voltage. I did this one at about 25 volts, and you can see it's kind of a purpley color. But you can get a variety of colors, and I'll put a chart up here in the corner just to give you some ideas. One thing is the DC power supply that I used, I actually have returned. It's only a 30 volt. You can get a much wider range of colors by going all the way up to around 90 volts. So I just bought a different one that'll go much higher. Again, I only did these at about 14 volts. I may have got a kind of a deeper color at a higher voltage, but I think this one's going to work out anyway for what I need. So hopefully you got something out of this one. I will be doing a follow-up video to show how to do anodization of something black, which is a different technique using a different chemical. So stay tuned for that. Thanks, folks. We'll see you on the next one.